I introduced y'all to the internet. I was the first artist to work with Domingos.
I'm the reason why it's Apple Music and Spotify.
I'm the reason there's Lil Pumps. I'm the first rapper to come out with a video game. So I discovered Chief Keef. Rista Keef used to sleep on my couch. I was the first artist on YouTube. Quavo met Travis Scott at my house.
Why you think you got an Instagram? That's me.
I'm the hottest rapper in the game right now.
I don't know that that's a fact, but in your mind it may be.
I created Nicki Minaj Twitter for her.
I'm shooting shots at everything. I ain't hitting no kids, but if them kids get in the way, I'ma feel sorry for them. I might just go into their funeral, drop a $100,000 on them.
We're an interracial couple. Of course my father-in-law thinks my husband could have did much better than a jigaboo like me.
Ish.
We're an interracial couple. Of course I don't love my wife. She's just a fetish to me.
Oh my God. Ginger? Oh.
Hey. We're an interracial couple. Of course my husband makes me do all the work around the house and call him master.
Dad, I know she's a gold digger, but this is what I want.
We spoke to Naisbitt in May.
Would you say that you're racist?
Not at all. No.
Yeah.
Look at my dog. He's as black as can be.
We're an interracial couple. Of course, when we take pictures, you can only see one of us and not the other.
Smile, babe.
This is what I'm talking about. To the point where the only way for you to make a living, the only way for you to even be seen is for you to be tap dancer.
We're an interracial couple. Of course, people tell me I need a DNA test because my baby's black.
Have you ever had a dream that you want him to do you so much you could do anything?
I'm an interracial couple. Of course I'm only with him for his 850 credit score.
Babe, I need you to come in here and apply for this for me.
Gotcha.
That's what I'm saying, man. I think black people just need a disability check, man. Just give him a check, man. Just give him a little check-in, man.
We're an interracial couple. Of course my father-in-law thinks my husband could have did much better than a jigaboo, jigaboo, a jigaboo, a jigaboo, a jigaboo, a jigaboo, a jigaboo, a jigaboo, a
Yeah, now, y'all know this was all her ideal, right? Yeah, I looked at a couple of videos of hers, right? And he actually seems like a good dude. You know, when you look at the way he talks and the way he is, got a good personality or whatever, you know what I mean? So the fucked up thing is, she probably actually has a real good husband, and she makes him have to perform in this bullshit. Because there's no way this white man told her, honey, I got a great idea. Why don't we get on that tickety-tock thing and take every vile, disgusting, racist stereotype we could think of and sell what little bit of dignity you have left for monetary gain? No, this was her idea. Matter of fact, not only was it her idea, she had to talk him into it. She said, baby, why don't we get on TikTok and make racially insensitive videos? He said, hell no. She asked the second time. He said, hell fucking no. She asked the third and a fourth. And then all the way on about the 25th time, you know what I mean? She said, but we can make some money. And then he said, money? How much money? And then she said, we can make hundreds of thousands of G's. And he said, hundreds of thousands of G's? You know what? Let's give it a test run. And then they put that test run out there, and that test run got 6 million views, and that 6 million views got them a 30, 40,000. I don't know the pay scale on a TikTok video, but you get my drift. That 6 million view video got them a $30, $40,000 check, more money than they've ever seen at once in their entire lives. And he was hooked. Hook, line, and sinker. And they've been doing performative bet witchery videos ever since. And I'm looking at her face, I can't tell if she's FBA or not. Them cheekbones look a little tetherish. I don't know, y'all tell me. But I do know this. Either way, it's not a good look. Foreign or domestic.